guys, this is PO PEX from Team Dynamic. Gonna do for you today a nuke video, tips and tricks. It's gonna be specifically on CT upper bump site retake setup. So we're gonna basically, on this strat, we're gonna give totally this upper bomb site to the terrorists. Now with the new DX81 flashes, it is really hard to hold this bomb site from every spot, basically. So even if you're playing rafters, you can get blind, forklift, you know, back fan, top of hot. All these good classic spots are like blindable, so you can get blind from everywhere. Some teams even like to throw flashes with two guys at the same time. For instance, they have one guy on this pillar and one guy on top of the vents. This guy on top of the vents can just follow that line, aim at this dot, jump and throw this flash. Right after, you can aim at this right here, jump and throw this flash too, right? So it is really hard to hold this bomb site, especially that this other guy at the same time can throw a flash just like this so it gets into the windows, and even like a flash like this so it gets into the other windows. So if the enemy flashes you like that, I wish you good luck onto the upper to hold this if they execute correctly, like two or three guys ready to plow out a hut and go out and do some damage. So that being said, I'll show you guys a setup that will counter a really massive upper take from the terrorists. It will make all the grenades useless and their strat not effective. First off, in this strat, we're gonna have three CTs coming at ramp at start. Two of them will stay in the ramp at two specific spots, and the one guy will just go lower. This guy who goes lower, what he's gonna do, he's just gonna chill in this corner right here for now. I'm gonna go back to him later. The two other guys. The first one, okay, he's gonna come here, flash this corner, just go straight, jump over this, get into this corner. Okay, this is a really good spot. Most likely, most of the time, flashes go behind you and stuff, and you can just counter them, or like this for instance, and then just have a quick left lean pick on them and stuff. It's really powerful. The other guy, so one goes lower, one jumps there, the other guy goes behind yellow here. This guy from right here, he can do a really nice flash that's not gonna blind his teammate on the wall. If he just throws like this when they're committing and peeks it, he's gonna flash the enemy and not flash his teammate. I'll show you right now. You see? The flash exploded right here in front of the connector, but it did not flash me at all. So this is a really good way to hold ramp with two rifles. On top of that, if the enemy decide to do a quick ramp take, as we know some teams like to do this, they come here, the first guy flashes far, and then the second guy behind flashes close, whatever. That's a lot of flashes, but it's not going to be good enough to hold three men at ramp. The guy who was going towards lower can just come back up, and then you have one guy here, one guy more like in this area, and one guy yellow. To shut down three rifles to shut down that rush. It's going to be really effective. So at this point of the strat, we have one lower, two ramp. Now I'm going to show you where the two other guys are. You have one guy at start who goes up tower. This guy can just spot hut safely. He does not want to get picked off, but he can just get information. He can spot hut, see if they rush. The other guy is just going to be an outside player. Depending if he's opping or colting, he can play it differently, obviously. If he has an op, he can play behind this pillar right here, and then he can op the door, he can even op to see if they drop on the roof and the outside area. If he has an op still, he can op this or this area, see if they're red, ops yellow. And if he wishes, he could even op from CT boxes like this, okay? I recommend him playing, there's two like way to do that setup, to play with the catwalk guy. I'll show you right now. If the tower guy, okay, on this retake setup is playing more catwalk, he's playing catwalk area, just like this, I recommend the outside player to play behind red area or behind the pole area, like more towards closer to outside, you know? If the guy is playing right here on the boxes, upping outside. I recommend the other player to be playing more like towards tower area, like this. I'll show you. Now, this is the first level. We got two towards outside, most likely, one lower, and two ramp. Now, I'll show you what everybody does specifically to retake correctly the upper bomb site. This is where it gets tricky, and this is where the execution has to be perfect. So, let me start with this guy rafters. If the guy rafters is playing more with the outside, if they're playing the close outside setup, let's say, this guy right here can just come here, okay? You can play, you just put yourself close to this edge and make sure you're above this big box. Put your crosshair tightly over this wall and you jump and throw. It breaks the windows and flashes upper. So this guy, okay, when he's playing outside right here, he can be ready, just be ready in a second to do those flashes, and he can flash this, okay? At the same time, okay, this guy right after, a good way to drop, say, so drop right here and be ready to go into the mini area. If you guys are doing that setup, their upper outside, okay, he can make his goal is to make sure that these guys from the T side, they don't push out of mini, okay? Because the goal of this from these two guys is to control the mini area. So this upper or rifle, even if he rifles, he can come here and make sure that they just don't push out. So after that, whenever you guys are ready to retake, you two guys are gonna be two together retaking from mini. Alright. Let's go to the ramp boys. Let's start with the lower guy. The lower guy, at start, he comes here and chill. Just want to say, if some teams like to drop lower on you since you gave upper, it's no biggie, because this guy will just have a lot of fun shooting them down when they drop up the vents. Nobody expects somebody to be chilling in this corner, like, who sees that? So, let's just go back to our upper retake. On the regular upper retake, whenever you guys are ready to call the retake upper, this guy is going to do a really useful smoke. He's going to get close to this edge. Just going to put his cross there, right there, so it gets stuck in onto the pillar, right? So this guy smokes this. I'll show you what the smoke does. This smoke, okay, smokes all out hot windows, so you can't see anything here. Smokes out squeaky, so you can't see anything. Plus, on top of that, whenever you go up, you get covered by this, and you can just clear this vent area and stuff. So this is a really effective smoke. This guy will just throw that smoke, and then break this vent, be ready to plow right after his teammate flashes. Alright, so now let's go back to the ramp guys. One of the yellow ramp guy right here is gonna go back under heaven. Okay, this guy under heaven is just gonna place his crosshair like this. He's gonna crouch. You just put yourself between those two pillars. You crouch, just put your crosshair right there in the corner of the square. And don't worry, the smoke is gonna go through the blue pillar. Let's chase the smoke. As you can see, the smoke covers everything out of hut. Like, if the terrace goes out of this, he's gonna be really in the smoke and won't be able to see anything. On top of that, since there's a lot of light from the sun and from the lights there, you can see through the smoke a little bit. So if there's, as you can see, I could see the floor here. So if the terrace goes out of this, you'll be able to see him a little bit. See, I can see the floor a little bit here and stuff. So you can be able to see him and you won't be able to see anything. At the same time, this under tower guy can throw a smoke and just like he can pop flash right after and chase it, right? Boom. And then you retake upper. So that's his goal here. Let me just go back to outside setup real fast, because if you guys were playing, let's say, CT and heaven on another scenario, this guy from here could have just flashed the windows just like this, you know? That's another way. But I suggest you guys to do the one I showed with this guy and this guy, because what's really good on that setup, like I said, is that you got mini locked down big time, so their terrorist is not gonna push out of mini. So let me go back to this guy right here. He's doing this, and then we have the rem guy. the ram guy has the opportunity to push or the fallback with his teammates. But the goal of this is to squeeze from as much angles as possible the upper bomb site. Right now we have vents, we have tower, and we have mini. So the other thing that this guy could do is he can flank lobby. What I suggest this guy to do is to flank it slow. This guy can hold it right here, just wait a little bit, and whenever the boys start smoking, this guy under heaven, he smokes this, the guy under vents smoke this, the terrorists are really gonna get nuts. The terrorists who will be on site will be totally blind, obviously, so you guys can retake, and whenever those smokes comes up, the terrorist lobby will definitely get crazy in this area. They'll be like, oh my god, we're getting smoked out, what shall I do here, okay? So this is, at this point, this guy should just be patient, and whenever the smokes are up, you wait 2 seconds and then you start flanking. These guys will get definitely like in a danger zone and will be like, oh my god, we gotta move out. So this guy can flank them correctly right here. And then, boom, surprise them, flank the guy who's the last man standing, LMS right here, whatever. So, this strat is an upper retake setup. It asks a lot of team play, but it can be easily executed. Everybody has to do the correct smoke and flashes. So, as you know, this guy on the tower is gonna smoke this. The guy vents is gonna smoke this. One guy is gonna flank lobby. This guy's gonna flash here. This guy's gonna flash from catwalk. Then we're gonna, everything on this bomb site will be blind, right? And then, so if you guys retake, this guy pops out vents, you guys retake mini, one guy tower, like, you guys will definitely kill the people on the bomb site, and the rest will be like stuck into lobby area and hot and squeaky room, and they will be definitely in a very bad situation. So this is dynamic specific retake CT upper strat, and I wish you guys enjoyed it. See you next time.
Make sure to stay updated on our player blogs. You can locate them under Community and then Blogs. For certain players' blogs, simply go to the player page. And also make sure to stay updated and like us on Facebook.com/TeamDynamic.